class of editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding salesman versus statesmanship written by T.P. Srinivasan. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2 plus. This is very, very important for political science optional students. Now what is this editorial about? This editorial is about the comparative analysis of the two phases of Indian foreign policy setups. Now the first setup that we had, it was established by the Jawaharlal Nehru, Indira Gandhi, Rajiv Gandhi era, and now we are entering into new phase of Indian foreign policy setup in which the things are entirely changing. We are actually heightening ourselves, we are actually dichotomizing ourselves, we are actually breaking ourselves from the precedent, from what we had bequeathed. So we are trying to metamorphose our entire foreign policy into something new that was non-existent till date. And here comes the differentiation between what is meant by a salesmanship and what is meant by a statesmanship. Now, as far as the asset that we currently own because of the Jawaharlal Nehru, Indira Gandhi and Rajiv Gandhi era, we are trying to squander away that asset. Now, what was that asset? The biggest asset that India had in the foreign policy, it was about NAM, non-aligned movement. Now, another biggest asset that India had was to project the idea of nuclear disarmament. Another idea, another part of the asset that India had, it was the kind of the soft power with which it was hitting really hard to the big powers of that time in order to democratize the international fora, institutions and functionality. It was because of this asset India had been able to exert itself with such a potential and with such a potency. But now what is India doing? How we are currently projecting Indian foreign policy? Now what we are doing is we are just selling ourselves. Earlier, we were selling the idea. We were selling the idea of non-aligned movement. And this idea had helped about 80 plus countries to be autonomous, to have strategic autonomy, to have independence. This idea of NAM had helped the developing countries to remain out of the two big blocks, the block of capitalism and the block of communism and socialism. Though NAM never said, NAM never tried to project itself as a neutrality fora or a fora of isolation. NAM had always stood for the things that were right. So India was doing what was close to the ethics, what was close to the global and the international politic ethics. Because of this, India was adopted as a father figure by the developing countries, by the third world countries. We were not party to the developed worlds. We were not party to the socialistic or the communistic setup and therefore us. This had helped India to create its own kind of space in the international diplomacy landscape. It is because we were acting more ethically. We were acting in a more egalitarian manner. We were acting in a more equitable manner. We were projecting human rights. We were projecting democracy. We were projecting welfare. We were projecting neutrality. We were projecting the creation of new international economic order. Now this Think of new international economic order. It came to the world fora because of the efforts made by the developing countries of Brazil, South Africa, India, China. But mainly it was the attempt of India that had projected this idea of new international economic order. Now again, with this idea, any number of developing countries were feeling associated. So the foreign policy that we had followed till now, because of the legacy of the Nehrus and the Gandhis, we have been able to align lot of countries behind us. They were actually pushing up the idea of India. So India had never projected itself as a singular power. India has never projected itself as a unique power. India was always trying to project itself as a representative of a unique and equitable idea. Now this has created a big kind of change in the world order that were prevalent at that point of time. It had created a lot of credibility for India. It had created a lot of respect for India. It had created a lot of reverence for India. It had created lot and lot of a kind of softness which was missing in the world diplomatic order. The softness, the power of softness was something that was exhibited by the Indian foreign policy. Now on the other hand, now what we are trying to do? From softness, we are moving towards hardness, the way we are selling the idea of India. Now we are becoming like a salesman. Now while becoming a salesman, we have actually distanced ourselves. We have created a gap, we have created a hiatus with the developing countries. पहले हमारे पीछे बहुत देशों के इंटरेस्ट्स को हम प्रोजेक्ट कर रहे थे, अभी इंडिया अपने इंटरेस्ट्स को अलग से पेश कर रहा है. Now India's interest vis-a-vis WTO, India's interest vis-a-vis climatic change, India's interest vis-a-vis UN, they are getting different from the interests of the poor countries. We are no longer a father, like a father figure. We are no longer a representative of the poor countries, because India's own interests have become biased. So we have actually moved from the idealistic setup to the very realistic, rude and crude setup in foreign policy realm. And this, now the big question is, will this realistic setup that we are currently following and pursuing, will it lead to some substantive result or not? Because we have got a lot out of the resource that was left behind by the Nehru, that was left behind by the Rajiv Gandhi and Indira Gandhi. It was their firm stance that had helped India to sign up nuclear deal with n number of countries. Now getting up a waiver from NSGU was a very big thing, and that had been possible because of India's softness. Now take the case of North America, take the case of Iran. North America was part of NPT, Non-Proliferation Treaty, since the days when it was formed in 1969. Now in order to have access to the aid, North Korea had conducted the nuclear tests thrice, in 2006, in 2009 and in 2012. But India had put up a self-restraint on itself, a moratorium on itself. India has never projected itself as a singular country. India has projected and India has sold the idea of global humanism, fraternity and brotherhood and peace and disarmament. Now what we are selling is India. Come, make in India. So this is a kind of a change that we have witnessed in Indian foreign policy. And because of that, there's a shift from statesmanship to the salesmanship. So this was all for the tutorial. Decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is EIAS Mentors. You can contact me at 845-940-000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. And you must also write answers on brainyki.com. It's very, very important to write and practice questions for your mains examination. This is especially for 2016 students. We will also be providing you with answer writing classes, and all these are done free of cost. So don't shy away, do write the answers. And please do install our application. Name of the application is Brainyki. You can find that application from Google Play Store and from App Store. And in case you like this video, do click on the like button. Do share and comment on this video. And plus, do share brainyki.com and eiasmentors.com on your Facebook pages. This will help us to grow. So bye-bye, take care. Have a nice day.